Color me not surprised when we hear about the latest rumors about the future of DCU, considering some of the characters that were in the DCEU that might be appearing and moving forward in the DCU itself from James Gunn. The worry was always, at least in my mind, that they were going to bring back Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn for a fourth time to try and get this character over, this abomination, this terrible version of Harley Quinn that has somehow seeped into the DCEU and likely has a future home in the DCU. There are rumors going around, and a couple of people are talking about it, one specifically that I trust, that I have a relationship with, that I believe has some pretty good information on that. And he's been right a lot of times on this. Well, let's get to these rumors that I absolutely hope are not true, and I'll explain to you why I don't like. Margot Robbie is rumored to return as Joker's former girl, Harley Quinn, when the new DCU gets going. We have been hearing this one quite a bit to a degree of certainty, although doubt gets cast on it when we have no way of knowing when the Snyderverse continuity will be canon and what won't be. Social media scooper My Time to Shine Hello tells everyone in a Twitter post not to worry, Robbie will be back, and this can be 100% confirmed. I can confirm Margot Robbie will be back as Harley Quinn in the DCU, says the post. And I imagine after all the success of Barbie being like the $1 billion flick, and I think Margot Robbie made well over $40 million for that movie, she's also a producer on it, that Warner Brothers were probably like, hey, a star is born. We finally got this lady over as a solo act, as a big-time A-list Hollywood star. Let's get her into our big DCU project that we have a lot of hopes and aspirations, and we have obviously dedicated a lot of time and manpower into getting over. Talking about the DCU and now the DCU moving forward, James Gunn has been cherry picking the things that he wants to bring forward and the things that he doesn't want to bring forward. Me personally, this is why I wouldn't bring Margot Robbie forward as Harley Quinn. She's basically been the star of three DC movies already. The original Suicide Squad, Harley Quinn, The Birds of Prey, and The Fabulous Emancipation of Harley Quinn, or something stupid like that. And then The Suicide Squad, the James Gunn movie, which obviously indicates James Gunn has a relationship with Harley Quinn. And if you look at James Gunn's girlfriend, wife, I'm not sure what she is, his loved one, his main squeeze, you can see why he might like Margot Robbie. There are some similarities just as far as some of the basic features of the two females themselves. So I imagine he is somewhat smitten with the character, but she's already swung and missed three times. Margot Robbie basically has failed as Harley Quinn as a starring character in three different vehicles on this one. And it's just time for something new. It's time for a different version of this character. Let's go back to the one from the actual Batman, the animated series, that everyone liked and respected and had something interesting going along with that character. Not to mention the fact that Lady Gaga, who I personally believe is a better actress than Margot Robbie, is going to be playing kind of that version of Harley Quinn, or at least it looks like it, based on the photos that we do have in the Joker sequel that's coming up. Obviously, that's a sequel to a $1 billion movie, and it's probably going to outshine and look better as the character and be a better interpretation of Harley Quinn to begin with than what Margot Robbie has done or is even able to do in the future. It's probably just time to move on. If you want to bring Harley Quinn back into the DCU moving forward, I say do it with a connection to the Joker, and maybe you can have a long, you know, big character arc similar to what started in Batman the Animated Series and then has ended, you know, within the last 5 years or whatever, to where she finally gets rid of the Joker, she becomes her own woman, and then, you know, she falls in love with Poison Ivy. And we can all see what that has done to the character in comic books. It basically made her stagnant, stale, and has held her in a single place where basically the character is dead in comic books too. Harley Quinn has a future in entertainment. I just don't think it's with Margot Robbie. She's had enough chances. And I do believe Lady Gaga is the future of Harley Quinn as we know her on the big screen, and they're just waiting to fail this one. My Time to Shine Hello is not the only one talking about this. YouTuber Sil Abdul has heard the same thing, and it is beyond dispute now that part of James Gunn and Peter Safran's plan is to ditch some actors and keep others. Abdul stated, I am being told, do not rule out Margot Robbie yet, and maybe, I guess, don't rule her in yet either. Pretty much a 50-50 situation, pretty good friends with Gunn as well, and I think she's going to carry that on since it's a reboot. Nothing has to be in continuity of what happened before, he continued. So if I'm going to bet on it today, I consistently heard Henry Cavill was out, Ben Affleck was out, Gal Gadot was out. I was hearing at the same time that Margot Robbie was in along with Joe Manganiello. And we never even really saw Joe Manganiello. He was supposed to be Deathstroke, I believe. And he was going to be in that really badass Ben Affleck directed and starring in Batman movie that we never got because Walter Hamada is a moron. It ruined everything about the Snyderverse and what it could have been when it came to the DCEU. And there we get YouTuber Sil Abdul somewhat confirming, soft confirming, the original scoop that we got on there. And I know a lot of people like to give Syl crap. I don't know why. I like Syl. He's been on the channel quite a few times. He's actually a really nice guy. And they like to give him crap when his scoops are wrong. But here's the thing that you got to understand when you're doing scoops is people are giving you information. They're feeding you information. And a lot of times it's BS. And sometimes it's going to be partially true. And maybe sometimes it'll even be 100% true. But most of the people that are feeding you information are doing it for like their own reasons. They have their own self-interest in mind. Maybe it's to make somebody else look bad. Maybe it's to make somebody else look bad. Maybe it's to make yourself look good. But you're working with one very narrow perspective of what's going on. And a lot of times people would actually feed you information just to make somebody look bad or something like that, even if it's only a small part of it that's actually true. But there's been enough stuff that Syl has reported on in Scoop over the last couple of years, especially with the DC studio stuff, where he's actually pretty reliable. He seems to have good sources. When you're a scooper, you're never, ever in your lifetime going to get 100% of everything correct. It was kind of like when I was in my military intelligence state. You know, I'm sitting there in Afghanistan and people are feeding you information, but it was always with their own self-interest in mind. So you had to kind of keep that in mind. And you couldn't just act on a single piece of information. When I say act on it, we're talking sending military forces. So the consequences of such actions could lead to some really, bad circumstances, some bad outcomes. So you had to be a lot more sure. Then obviously going on to YouTube and talking about the scoops or the rumors that you have with DC Studios. So Syl could run with a story or a scoop here and there that he might not believe is 100% true, but does have some basis in fact with it and move along there, knowing that nobody's going to die. Whereas when you're a military intelligence guy, you have to be a little bit more sure. You have to have more sources to it. And you actually have to make sure that the original source isn't the second source. We call that with circular reporting, where somebody gets to you, they're like, hey, did you hear this? And you're like, wow, that confirms exactly what I just came up with 24 hours ago. Where did you hear that? Where did that actually come from? And a lot of times you would find out it actually came from the original source, but somehow came back to you as a secondary source. You know, it was interesting stuff. My military intelligence kind of days. That's why I'm somewhat good and reliable at this job right here, because I'm good at looking at the pieces of the puzzle, the bits and pieces of information that are available, and actually putting together more of a total picture, because essentially that's what I did for like 16 years in the military. Now, when it comes to this particular scoop from Syl Abdul and My Time to Shine Hello, I actually believe it's true because it kind of falls in line with what we've seen James Gunn do in the past, even before he was the co-CEO of DC Studios, you know, his time as a director and stuff like that. This was famously the case in The Suicide Squad when Gunn held on to key players from the David Ayers cast, including Margot Robbie. We also know that Viola Davis will be back as Amanda Waller, and John Cena will play Peacemaker again, even if it takes a few years to get a second season. Keeping Robbie around after the smashing success of Barbie is only logical. And those opinions there at the end are actually from Bounding Into Comics, who had the article on this, and I do want to give them a little shout out. A little tip of the cap, a salute, sir. Good reporting on that one. And it is only logical at this point. Warner Brothers as a studio have actually poured a ton of money into Margot Robbie as an A-list star within Hollywood, and it never really worked out. Now that this has finally bore some fruit, and we've got the Barbie movie making so much money, she's the producer on this one, I imagine Warner Brothers are going to want to keep her in-house and move forward with her version of Harley Quinn, which I don't think is a very good version of Harley Quinn. And I certainly hope that Margot Robbie moves on to bigger, better things like a Barbie sequel and maybe, I don't know, like a kid sister movie or something like that, and leave the superhero stuff out of it. Because at this point, it's almost going to be like a Jennifer Lawrence situation. Remember, she was cast in X-Men First Class or whatever, and she wasn't really a star then. She'd have been in a couple of movies, but she's cast as Mystique. And along the way, Hunger Games comes out, she becomes one of the bigger stars in the world, one of the more notable stars in the world. And by the time you get to the end of that and you get to that apocalypse movie, like somehow like Mystique is the fucking leader because Jennifer Lawrence is such an enormous star in comparison to the other actors in the movie. And you're like, this doesn't make any sense whatsoever, but it is Jennifer Lawrence and she doesn't want to dress up in blue paint anymore, which kind of makes sense. And she's the biggest star on the screen, so she likely has the largest salary. So she's got to have the big part and like overshadow Professor X and Magneto and all the other cool heroes in there. And you're like, this doesn't really make sense. I could see that actually happening with Margot Robbie and Harley Quinn. And Harley Quinn was already too big of a part in the other movies. Harley Quinn was too big of a part in Birds of Prey and the Fabulous Emancipation of Harley Quinn herself. She's not a bird of prey. She shouldn't have been in that to begin with. And if she wasn't it, she should have been a little bit part of the side. She probably should have just been the damn villain of it instead of on the team. And that's another part. It's like, they're just going to make her a hero. They're not going to have Margot Robbie the star of Barbie be a villain like she's supposed to be. Go out there, find some new blood, find somebody fresh to play Harley Quinn in the future. Just don't do it anytime soon, because Lady Gaga is going to make him look stupid and probably look pretty good in the Harley Quinn role in this Joker sequel that's coming up in the not-too-distant future. Earlier in the video, I was talking about the really sad state of Harley Quinn in comic books, where she's basically in this state where she can't be moved, and anytime they try to move her, everyone yells and screams, no, she needs to be back with Poison Ivy. They need to be making out and talking about having sex together, because Harley Quinn is in the perfect place and she can never move on. She can't be a villain anymore. It doesn't matter that she murdered an entire city's children all in one night using fake Christmas presents. She's a goddamn national treasure nowadays. And basically, there's nothing that you could do with the character other than ruin her further. If you would like an example, this is obviously as bad as it gets, the example I'm going to show you here. But if you want to see what T. Franklin did with Harley Quinn and Peg Leg Beyonce, you got to see this right now, because this is absolutely awful. Some of the worst comic book writing in the history of the world, specifically with Harley Quinn. There's also a link in the video description.